Hi, thanks for joining. This video will focus on trichoscopy of scalp psoriasis and other inflammatory scalp diseases. Clinically, scalp psoriasis may have multiple different manifestations, but the three most important for me are the inflammatory scalp disease, the non-cicatricial alopecia, and the cicatricial alopecia. This is a typical trichoscopy image of psoriasis of a moderate activity with visible blood vessels and some diffuse scaling. A very typical trichoscopy feature of scalp psoriasis is the presence of multiple blood vessels which are arranged either in lines or in circles. And when we use a handheld dermoscope, these blood vessels appear usually as dots. If we use high magnification, for example, with a digital dermoscope, we will see that they have a glomerular structure. And the name comes from the glomerulus and the kidney because somebody who described this feature believed that these structures are visually very similar. So the number one feature of scalp psoriasis in trichoscopy is the presence of red dots in linear or circular arrangement with a handheld dermoscope, and with a video dermoscope or digital dermoscope, we will see the glomerular arrangement of the vessels. The second feature of scalp psoriasis is the presence of the so-called lace-like vessels. They also may be arranged in circles or in lines. These two images, one, the left one in a lower magnification, and the right one in the higher magnification, show these lace-like vessels. I have pointed with a blue arrow to one of them, which I believe that it is especially beautiful. Number three, the extravasations. It seems that the extravasations, similar to the sphincter hemorrhages in the nails, are a feature of high disease activity. They may develop spontaneously or by scratching or other type of mechanical injury, just as it happens with the Auspitz sign. Number four, the pink background. Unlike many other inflammatory diseases of the scalp, in psoriasis, the background is almost always pink in color. Number five, diffuse scaling. These may be very thick or sometimes just thin scales. They are usually silver white in color, sometimes a bit yellowish. Occasionally, it may be necessary to use a keratolytic agent to remove the scales to be able to visualize the blood vessels. Or another method is to take a look at the border of the lesion, because there usually the scales are not so severe, not so thick, and the blood vessels may be visible. Please also be aware of the fact that sometimes, especially if you use polarized dermoscopy, that sometimes these scales may concentrate around the hair follicles, and this may be mimicking lichen planopilaris, so we should be aware of this possibility. Clinically, the main differential diagnosis of psoriasis is seborrheic dermatitis. In trichoscopy, they look totally different. First of all, in seborrheic dermatitis, you will not see the typical trichoscopy features which I mentioned just a moment ago. There is no clear typical trichoscopy feature of seborrheic dermatitis. We may see some arborizing vessels, but they may be also present in healthy individuals. They may be more prominent, they may be a little bit thicker, there may be more of them. So this is just a matter of rather the quantity than the quality. I would say that seborrheic dermatitis still remains a diagnosis of exclusion in terms of using the dermoscope. Both in psoriasis and in seborrheic dermatitis, we will see the diffuse scaling. It is usually thicker in psoriasis and a little bit thinner in seborrheic dermatitis. It may have a tendency to be more yellowish in seborrheic dermatitis, but this again is not a difference which is qualitative, it is quantitative. Pseudotinea amiantacea may be a manifestation of many diseases, including psoriasis. And here you see the typical trichoscopy image of pseudotinea amiantacea with a typical hair cast, multiple hair casts. Again, just to repeat, this is not typical of psoriasis. This may be present in any disease which has this clinical manifestation. This is a clinical image of cicatricial alopecia in the course of psoriasis and an image of psoriatic cicatricial alopecia. Trichoscopy in this case shows an area with no follicular openings, no dots, indicating that most probably there are no hair follicles. There are multiple blood vessels, partly arranged very regularly. In some parts, these are the lace-like blood vessels. And also, there's an extravasation or maybe just a sign of mechanical scratch. So to summarize this presentation, the key trichoscopy features of scalp psoriasis are the clusters of regularly distributed blood vessels, either in a linear or in a circular arrangement. Second, the presence of the so-called lace-like blood vessels, the blood extravasations, the pink background, and the diffuse scaling. And of course, in most cases, you will not see all five features, but just a few of them, or even only one of them may be present. If you would like to hear more about hair diseases or about trichoscopy, feel free to take a look at my YouTube channel. Thanks a lot.